QR codes, ladies and gentlemen. That big QR code that you see on the screen, Mo, please put it up there again. It says scan me. We are currently in the process right now of running a 20% off sale for my perfume, everything. So this is the time now that we are running 20% off everything perfume. Click that QR code that's up there on the screen. Click the QR code there on the screen so that you can get 20% off of 20% off again, 20% off of the perfume. You say shipping takes forever. Listen, Duran, I love you, babe. And you were one of the first people to get it. And I thank you so much. But I've been on their ass. I've listened to everything that you guys have said, everything that you guys have talked about. The packaging is about to change. The labels are about to change. It's a whole bunch of stuff. I've listened thoroughly to you guys. And I have been one-on-one with the company. And we have made changes. Okay. So right now, you know, 20% off of the perfume right now. Now, the shipping, I hope the shipping don't take forever. You tell me you got shipping problems and I'm on their ass. You tell me they got shipping problems, I'm on their ass. Oh, you say you're talking about another brand? Okay, thank you, my baby. But I'm listening. Everything that you guys have told me, every problem, every issue that you've told me that you've had with the company that I'm partnered with, the reason why I love that company is because they let me create my perfume. They let me create it. And I went back and forth. I have been working on this perfume, Craig, for a while. I've been working on this perfume for like a year. And then in the last stretch of the 6 months, I was down to what I want the smell to smell like because I know how I smell. And I said, this perfume has to smell exactly like me. And if you guys have got the perfume, and you've actually met me in person, you guys know that the perfume smells exactly like how I smell. This is exactly how I smell. This right here. This is right here. How I smell. And so at the checkout, you put in Maddie 20. That's how you get your 20% off. At the checkout, you put in Maddie 20. Thank you, Skin Potion. Now, who I am going to partner up with, because you know I'm very transparent. Y'all know I'm transparent. I've been begging and communicating heavy with the company. I've been telling them, listen, the mob likes lotions, butters, creams, and sprays, and ointments. But this is what the mob likes. The mob likes these smells. And so because the mob likes these smells, we need a roll-on. We need a body mist out of the shower. These are the things that we need. And so I need for you to get in motion and get in rotation of providing this for the mob, because this is what the mob is asking me for. We need this stuff. Now, in the meantime, I will link up with Skin Potion because I know how Skin Potion product is. Skin Potion product is amazing. When I say the Skin Potion product is amazing, Skin Potion product is extremely amazing. And paired with everything, it just takes that shit to another level. I says, what's the QR code? Mo, put the QR code back on. Put it back on my face, Mo.
The sound don't help, Maddie.
It don't.
No, it don't help.
Yes, it's it. Why did you take it down? Put it back. They didn't get it.
How do you know?
They didn't. Scan me. Mo, stop taking it down.
Maddie.
This is why you ain't got no girl now. Put it back. Put it back on my face. Put it back.
Why are you like this?
Because I'm a fag. A popular hot ass gossiper.
You'll tell me when to take it off?
I will.
Okay.
Not now. I haven't gotten it all yet. I haven't gotten all of it yet.
Okay. Let me know when you finish.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Now, no, I'm not done. No.
How long do you want it up?
I need it up as long as I need it. Put it back. Now, while you're in, while I do that, I need you to write down in the comments what the code is. Maddie 20, M-A-D-D-I-E 20. Maddie 20.
20.
Maddie 20.
Oh my God. You not finished?
Scan me, Mo. Scan me.
Oh my God.
Okay, you can take it down now. I'm done.
For now.
Yes, until I need it again. Well, learn how to please a woman and then you'll have a woman.
How about when you tie it?
I never get tired. Ladies, if you got good pussy to never get tired, put a one in the chat. Ladies, if you got good pussy and you never get tired, put a one in the chat. And ladies, because you can have nuts too and be a lady. If you got good pussy and don't never get tired, ladies, put a one in the motherfucking chat. Then look at all my ladies out there. See, Mo, look at all my ladies.
Those are lies. Because if a man come to you every hour talking about I want some, y'all gonna be sick and tired.
Y'all if like, y'all ladies got good pussy out there in the chat, good pussy out there in the chat, because good pussy don't never get tired, put a one.
I don't believe it. Pussy be getting tired.
Who you told you that? I don't even got a pussy. I know that's not the truth. Wait a minute, somebody put two. Oh my God. That's somebody saying, listen, I ain't even gonna allow my pussy. Aaron said, I ain't even allow my pussy.
Thank you for being truthful. Thank you for being truthful.
Oh. Oh my God.
Oh my goodness.
Oh God. So, guys, I'd like to ask y'all a question, and I want y'all to be truthful and honest with me about this question I'm getting ready to ask. Do you guys want me on Foxo? Do y'all want me on Foxo?
Let us know. Let us know.
I mean, I have a really good time when I go on Foxo. What is Miss Mitt? What is Mom?
What is Craig? It's her and Craig.
You know, Craig done went out there just.
He went up there.
Say y'all do.
They saying yes.
Y'all saying no.
Oh, yeah, some people are saying.
Oh, I want to explain something to y'all, right?
They saying too filtered. They said they're too filtered.
What? Here's the thing about me being filtered when I occupy other people's spaces. I'm filtered when I occupy other people's spaces because I understand that it's not my platform. And I know that I can't say, motherfucker, kiss my ass, suck my dick, fuck you, punk, pussy, bitch, raggedy ass. I can't talk about people's kids over there. I can't read people's, you know, I can't read the way that I want to over there because that's not my place. I know one thing the mob has to understand. Did Craig go outside?
I don't know. He might have.
The one thing that the mob has to understand that no matter where I go, that whether it's Drag Race, whether it's MTV, whether it's Paramount Plus, whether it's WeTV, whether it's AMC Plus, I can't take the raw T.S. Madison to that place because they don't understand that. And they can't. The raw T.S. Madison is an unfiltered, controlled entity that we own, that we can have here with each other.
Right.
So I feel that I could be a permanent rotating guest. Plus, y'all know I be working. Bitch, I be filming. I be hosting. Someone asked me yesterday, they said, T.S. Madison, who do you think you are? What do you think you are? And my answer was, I am an entertainer. I'm not just a comedian. I'm not just a content creator. I'm not a YouTuber. I'm not just these things. Like, I can occupy every space. And I like to occupy every space all at the same freaking time. And I don't like being locked into a space where I can't do everything else. So with that being said, I just ask you, because when I come into a situation and I'm going to give y'all the Maddie that's going to fit into a pick. I'm a chameleon. I'm a Libra. I can mesh with anything. I'm fluorescent beige. I'm still black, but I'm fluorescent beige. I can fit into anything. I'm a one size fit all. Anyway.
A jacklet of all trades?
Yes, I'm a jack of all trades.
I say jacklet.
Oh, I like that, Mo. See, Mo, this is why I love Mo, because he's so respectful of my identity. He's so respectful of my pronouns, because he knows all he sees is she, her, and hers. That's all he sees. Right, Mo? Mm-hmm. That's it. I don't understand why people can't get out there in the world and just respect people for exactly what they are. I haven't told Mo one time to change his Muslim beliefs. Not once have I said,
when have I ever told you I was Muslim?
It's not, you got on his head wrap.
That's because my hair ain't done right. Hey, who told you Muslims wear head wraps?
I've seen them.
You mean like the caps that they wear?
Yeah.
This isn't a cap. This is a I don't even know what to say. It's more like a, almost like a male body, I'll say.
Mo, how much do you tap into your feminine side? Do you tap into it at all?
What defines my feminine side?
I don't know. Do you just tap into your feminine side at all? As a heterosexual identified man.
Like, the reason I'm asking is like, because what is considered the feminine side? Like,
it all depends on what the public constitutes feminine sides to be. Because,
like, do I like to dress?
Like, when people, here's the thing.
Do I like to get my hair done? Yeah, I like to get my hair done.
So that's feminine?
I don't know. Would you
consider? So according to a social construct, would that be deemed feminine, getting your hair done?
Yeah, because I go to the salon. I don't go to the barbershop. I go to the salon.
Or the salon comes to you. I taught you that, didn't
That's
I?
True. You're right. Or the salon comes
it's
to me.
It's called upper echelon. Step your pussy out.
And I cover my head every time I go to sleep.
Well, that's Muslim, right?
That, Maddie, that is not Muslim. That is not Muslim.
Oh. Okay.
You see?
I'm just trying to find out.
You see?
Because I was not, you know.
Really?
Introduced a lot of cultures outside of being ghetto.